College football, the campus of Rutgers University in Piscataway, New Jersey, where the game will be a little more technical, but no less intense than that showdown with Princeton in 1869. Today, a Big Ten clash, and you know when you square off against a conference opponent, the blood boils a little hotter. As we'll see, the UCLA Bruins taking on the Rutgers Scarlet Knights. For EA Sports College Football, Reese Davis with you alongside David Pollack and Jesse Palmer. Time to get this game started. And the Scarlet Knights will put toe to leather to crank us up. He'll bring it out. It's Sturdivant. Rolling the dice to bring it out of the end zone did not work out as he stopped at the 13. The Bruins offense will have plenty of work to do after that return was bottled up. And there's a man who believes he is always open. He carries that swag and that aura of a big-time playmaker, guys.
He's got to catch the football. If you're the quarterback coming into this one, you are looking for this guy early, and David, you're looking for him often.
And this offense better find ways to feature him. Find him, like you said, Jesse, early, often, deep, shallow. Get this man the football.
The Bruins in the hurry up. Off the bootleg, wants to throw it. Quickly out to the tight end. And they'll shove him out of bounds after the short gain.
And you see tight end matchups all over the field all the time. Now, it used to just be in the red zone. Now, you just find the big fella, you put him in the slot, try to give him the ball as much as possible because you know he can make big plays.
This is the type of play that can give the offense momentum. Third and short from inside the 20. Got it set up on the outside. And they knock him down, but he got past the line to gain.
You know, it's a nice throw by the QB there. When you're throwing to running backs, you got to make it easy on them. So you want to put it right on their body, make the catch simple, and let them go to work like they did just there getting that first.
And the Bruins will have it first and 10. On the run, it's Harden. Defense in the right spot. They stop him after a gain of 2 to the 28.
They're strong and they're scrawl. Defensive tackles, they're scrawl. They're such big jokers in the middle where they just lock out those offensive linemen. And running backs, listen, they don't have much of a chance. When you got that 300-plus pound guy grabbing you around the shoulder pad, you tend to go to the ground pretty quickly.
Finds his tight end. And the defense had that one well covered, just a short game there. Look, you can't take away everything, right? So you give them that and rally and make a solid tackle.
Yeah, and a lot of times in zone coverage, I like when I can get all the eyes on the quarterback. I like when I can see the routes and see him develop in the middle. And you could tell they had keys on the tight end. He wasn't going anywhere after he caught that football.
Excellent coverage and good use of the hands to knock it away.
Third and short like that on your own side of the field, you're just looking for a quick hitter. You're trying to get the ball out of your hand quickly, but the timing completely off there for the offense, and the ball falls incomplete.
The Bruins will send out the punt unit. They'll have to punt for the first time this afternoon. He'll field the punt and look for room. Coverage team gets the job done, and they'll mark him down at the 38-yard line. So Rutgers offense has the ball for the first time. As we take a look at our impact players for this game, David, what do you look for to make an impact from your leaders?
Your leaders not only have to lead the football team, but they got to step up and make plays on the field, keep everybody calm. These guys typically do a really good job of it.
Yeah, David, and they also generally set the tone for their respective football teams. Regardless of which side of the ball they play on, the teammates look towards them to step up in big games like this.
They'll put it in play from the 41 on first down. Takes the handoff. It's Monaga. Crosses the 30. He's got away. He's run out of bounds, but not before turning in a big pickup and moving the sticks for a first down.
Defense is going to have their hands full trying to stop this guy. They better rally to the football and get multiple hats because he is not easy to bring down.
They're in the red zone, first and 10 from the 20. They're threatening to score, and they'll throw it. Catch in the middle. It's Miller. They get him down, but this offense is set up first and goal from the 9.
Well, you're seeing the balance this offense has and how they can create explosive plays in a variety of ways. We just saw one come in the run game, and now you see one coming in the passing game. I'll tell you, they've got this defense on their heels.
The Scarlet Knights have it in scoring position on first and goal. They'll try to get it in with the run. And he's swallowed up at the line of scrimmage by the big defensive tackle.
Man, nowhere to run on that play at all.
About all you can say is do better. But that's the problem. Are they able to do better?
And that's why you keep trying things, right? Keep trying to get on the perimeter, run it up the middle, try different things to see what you do well.
He'll run it up the middle, trying to pick his way to the end zone. Dragged down at the 6 after a pickup of 2.
This has been really good for the defense, too. It's kind of a bend-don't-break mentality, right? Really bowing up with your backs against the wall. If you can win this next third down, try to force the opponent into a field goal. That's a win if you're on defense.
Huge play in the red zone. Third and goal coming up. From the gun, wants to pass. And they fail to hook up on third down.
Third and short in college football today, you see so much more pass than you used to. The offense stays aggressive, and I think they stay aggressive because they know they're in field goal range. They got that 3 in their back pocket.
They'll try to salvage a field goal on this drive, and he'll try it from the right hash, and the angle shouldn't be too bad from this distance. And this one splits the uprights, and the first points of the day come on that field goal. So after the last drive ended with a field goal, the kickoff team out there to send it away. And he takes this from inside the 5. He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. The UCLA offense is back on the field, ready to go to work. From the gun, the running back has it. Really needed a play like that to get out of their own end. They move the chains. They mark it at the 29. The Bruins moving the chains on the ground, and they've had some great running backs there. Some have flown under the radar a little bit.
Yeah, guys like Jonathan Franklin. And listen, you can always find elite recruits and great playmakers out there in the Golden State.
He'll pull it on the read. Nowhere to run on that one. He loses 4 on the carry.
And how about the aggressiveness of this defense? I love this. Don't let him get to the sideline. Kept the ball in the middle of the field, went after the quarterback right away like some missiles, and got him on the ground.
Couldn't get him blocked on that last one. Now it's 2nd and 14. Back to pass. It's Garbers. He finds his man. Good, solid tackle.
That wide receiver on the outside is dangerous. When you're playing zone coverage, it's really hard because you're not chasing him. You can't really get hands on him. You got to make sure you send more guys his direction. Maybe slide those linebackers toward that wide receiver so you got a little more help on the outside.
And the Bruins come to the line in the hurry up. Wants to throw on third down. He's got it. Major gaps in that defense, and he got loose, and they finally knock him down at the 41.
This tight end is such a weapon because he can line up all over the field. That time he starts in the slot, he's running the corner route against zone coverage, and he's just got athleticism and wiggle and the ability to separate and make big plays. So nice to have a target like that.
Wide receiver shows motion. They'll leave it with him. That play just never had a chance. They knock him down for a loss of 5.
Well, the offensive line had everybody blocked except the defensive end. He was able to sneak into the backfield and get the tackle for loss.
Line getting set on 2nd down. He's got it again. And a good, solid pickup before the defense cuts him down.
And as an offense, having success on a run play like that early in the game just opens up all the possibilities of your playbook moving forward. Play action, running the ball, throwing the ball, screens, anything is at your disposal at this point.
If they can convert here, that type of play can really give you a shot of momentum. Quarterback extends the play, and he avoids the hit and slides after the short gain.
It's nice for this D coordinator when he puts his nickel package out on the field, because that nickel player he's got who subs in is good in coverage. He's also aggressive. He does a nice job blitzing, and he can play the run. They can spy the quarterback. There's a lot of different tools this guy's got to defend against a mobile quarterback, and I think you saw a little bit right there in that nickel package now setting up fourth and long.
And the Rutgers offense heads back onto the field. Always good to get points on a drive, David, but chip shot field goals can leave you a little empty.
And I think it's great to get points, but the great teams get touchdowns in the red area. You got to get out there this time and execute a little better on this drive.
You're absolutely right, David. Generally, the best red zone offenses are the ones that run the ball the best. So let's see if they can be a little bit more physical on this drive.
So much for the tough field position. One play and you're already to the 35. Quarterback, quick pass to the receiver. Fighting off the defender. Tackled after picking up the first down. Guys, it is Rutgers on top here at the end of the quarter. We've put one in the books. Let's have a look at our game summary. They've switched into the field, and we're ready to get things started here in the second. The offense setting up shop at the 46, first and 10. Out of the gun, the running back has it. They'll pick up four, second and six coming. Went to the running game on first down. Now here they come again. On second down, looking to throw. Just a short pass to the tight end. They get him on the ground, but not before he gets enough for the first down.
This offense is clicking, everything working together really well. Coordinator, quarterback, offensive line. Good rhythm, good flow. Defense is going to have to find something to kind of mess up this timing they got going on.
And the Scarlet Knights have it with a first and 10. The give to the back. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on that one.
You see all this movement in football now, all the stemming, the defensive line, they're sliding right before the snap, creating confusion for the offensive line. Then they're moving back and stunting. Really good job by the defense. Continue to move, continue to stunt, continue to get in the backfield and make this life hard on this running back.
The play action fake. Finds a man on the left. Ripping through the defense and getting it all the way down to the 24-yard line.
And I love the awareness by the wide receiver on that play, because I'm not sure that route was supposed to be that deep. You gotta wonder if the receiver decided maybe to adjust the route a little bit to make sure that he got the first down.
On the run, it's Monaga. Really nice run there. Good, solid pickup, and they'll move the sticks for the first down.
First down, you know you always want to establish the running game. How about this offense? Nothing fancy. Run the football, be physical, get a big game.
They've hit him with back-to-back chunk plays. Now it's first and goal. They move the tight end all over. They'll dial up the run on first and goal. He's dropped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of three.
They're trying to run the ball on first down, guys, but just nothing doing up front. Their offensive line got blown up on that play. There was nowhere for that guy to go.
Defense rolls up deep in its own end on that last play. Now a second and long coming. They'll keep it on the ground right up the gut, looking for six. Brought down at the seven after picking up three. Third and goal from way back there. From the gun, wants to pass. Didn't have anything working and just had to throw it away on third down.
After that incompletion, it's now fourth and short in the red zone. Decision time if you're the head coach. Just take the field goal, or do you keep your offense on the field looking to get six?
It's wise not to be too greedy, and they'll go ahead and send out the field goal unit. Right on target the first time. Now he'll try another from 24 yards out. Between the uprights, it's good. So after putting three on the board, the kickoff team is out there ready to boot it away. Fielded in the end zone, it's Jones. He's brought down at the 16, would have been much better off to take the touchback. UCLA will go back to work on offense. Running back goes in motion. They're going to open this drive with a pass. Grabbed in the backfield, it's Harden. And a good job of coverage by that defense, just a short pickup.
This defense is going to have to be careful. Not only do they have to worry about this guy running the football, but they've got to keep their eye on him when he runs routes, too. He is a versatile back.
The Bruins want to pick up the tempo. The run from the shotgun. And how about that interior defense stuffing the run for nothing?
Stopping the run is very high on every defensive coordinator's list. Making the team one-dimensional. Nice job stuffing the run on that play right there.
They line up, and it is a long way to the sticks from here. On third and long, he's going to have to throw for it. Almost intercepted. It'll fall incomplete. The defense almost came up with a turnover.
Wow, that quarterback is lucky there. If you're going to take a chance like that on third down in your end of the field, you better be right, because that should have been picked and returned for a touchdown. This offense is lucky now they're getting a chance to punt this ball around.
Fourth down, and the punt team sends it the other way. He'll call for the fair catch here. Rutgers has it back. They'll send the offense back onto the field. They finished the first two drives with field goals. They'd love to get a little something more this time, Jesse.
Want to just keep seeing balance from them and a little better execution as they get closer to the goal line. They've got the playmakers at receiver, at running back, and they love their offensive line, David. Just got to put it all together.
And I think once you start to move the football down the field, that area of the field when you get in field goal range, you got to be a little bit more physical. So listen, still a good start. Still got the lead and an opportunity to build on it here.
And wings it incomplete. After the second down misfire, looking at a third and eight. From the gun, wants to pass. Looking down the middle. Finds a tight end. And they exploited that soft spot, and they get it down to the 35. Love to see the fearlessness of a quarterback to work the middle of the field.
And he's got so much confidence in his own arm talent to be able to get that football there before the defense can break it up.
The Scarlet Knights will snap it on first and 10. Use the play fake, now to throw. Coming after it. Good job to avoid the negative play and just get rid of that thing.
And sometimes you got to know when to give it up, right? As a quarterback, you feel it. You can't hold it that second too long when bad things can really happen. You could tell the clock went off and he was throwing that puppy away.
After the misfire, it's second down. Looking for room, it's Monaga. He picks up four. That'll leave them with third and six. trying to pick up a first down. Trying to move the sticks on third down through the air. Gets it out fast. Really nice job there by both guys, the throw and the catch, to work that defense and get the first down.
Defense is about learning the plays. Third down, what do they like to do? How do they do it? So far, the offense having a little bit of success, but the defense now, you got to figure out what they're doing.
We've reached the two-minute warning, and we'll see if the offense can build on this lead before the break. And the Scarlet Knights are moving quickly down the field. Trying to find his man on first down. Got out of trouble, got rid of it. Tosses it incomplete. This offense has a second down play. He's looking to throw. And that's a mistake you don't expect to see from a senior, and he is lucky to get it back. They were on the move, but two straight incompletions have them staring at third and 10. Back to the air one more time. A little screen to the running back. Just trucks through it. Touchdown, Scarlet Knights! What a grab and go for the score.
The screen game is such a big part of this offense. A nice job by the quarterback holding on to it until the last possible second. And the O-line getting downfield, picking up their blocks. They make it about as easy as they can for this running back to find the end zone.
He'll try to tack on one more. And with the extra point, they stretch the lead to 13. So the touchdown drive goes 63 yards. And they finish it up with a 15-yard scoring toss. Lining up to cover the kick after that touchdown drive. He'll bring it back from inside his five. The UCLA offense is back on the field, ready to go to work. Getting late here in the first half, they'll have a chance to make this a one-possession game.
And the offensive play caller here has to really be dialed in. It's important, down two possessions, Dave, that they're able to score some points. And you've got to call your best stuff in this two-minute situation.
And such a good opportunity to cut into a one-score game, create that momentum, get some good juices going for the second half. Because obviously, you know, you built yourself a little bit of a deficit. You need some good things to happen, and it needs to happen on this possession.
Back to throw, it's Garbers. He's got the back in the middle. And the defense settled in to stop that one for a short gain.
And you see so many smart wide receivers, so many smart tight ends nowadays that they know where the holes in those zones are, and they work with their quarterback, and they find them, and they sit down in them and make big plays. It's tough to sit back in zone against such smart players nowadays.
They'll go to the air on third and short. Grabbed in the middle. It's Harden. Really nice pickup there as they have it out to the 44 with a first down. A timeout is called as this offense tries to find a way to get more points on the board before the half. To the air on first down. Snagged in the middle. It's Sturdivant. And it's on the ground. Oh, it looks as if the defense got it. And he's brought down, and this defense gets the ball back for its own.
And the unthinkable just happens. You're the offense. You're trailing in this game late in the first half. You're trying to be aggressive. You're trying to put some points on the board. But you can't turn the ball over. And now all of a sudden, they've given it back. And there's an opportunity for the opponent now to widen their lead.
And the Rutgers offense heads back onto the field. They unleashed an aerial assault last time that took them right to the end zone, David.
So, Reese, with that drive, I think you've accomplished something you wanted to accomplish. Make this defense think. You put them back on their heels. Now, shoot, Palmer, you might be able to slip a few runs in on this drive to really jack them up.
Yeah, I like that idea, but I also like the fact that speed kills, and they've got it at the receiver position, so if you've got one-on-one matchups, man, take advantage.
And the incompletion brings up a second down for this offense. He's looking to throw. Using the quick game, the offense will have to use its first timeout of the half.
It's definitely the wide receiver's job to create space, right? So whether you're running a go or you're running a hitch like this right here, I got to find a way to push off legally or just create a little bit of space to get some positive yards.
He hurls one deep down the left side. And this is dropped. Incomplete pass. He had a huge gain in his fingers and he couldn't hold on. As strange as it seems, this is an easy decision. A little too far for the field goal. Punting does nothing for you. They'll go for it on fourth down. Finds his man enough for the first. Well, they just drained all the suspense out of the fourth down conversion, moving the chains easily. The offense wastes no time getting the timeout call. The Scarlet Knights will line it up on first and 10. He's going to pass. Makes the grab over the middle. And he's able to shed one tackle and gets a pretty good pickup.
And quarterback dropping back, understanding. I'm getting zone coverage. All I got to do is be a little bit patient, manipulate that defense a little bit. My wide receiver runs that drag, and I get the first down.
We've got a timeout in the waning seconds of the half. Maybe a chance to get off a couple more plays. And here on second down, they'll send out the field goal unit to try to get three before the break. Not a particularly long kick from 36 yards out, but he'll have to guide it in from the left hash. He got it. And they'll push that lead out a little further. That late in the half field goal always gives you a little boost going to the locker room, and they'll need to finish off these final few seconds and not allow them to answer. From inside the 10-yard line, he'll bring it back. And the return man's journey is stopped, but there is a flag on the play. So the penalty will not be enforced. The defense declines and stands on the result of the play. We've played two quarters here. Time to go to Kevin Connors in our halftime update.
All right, guys. Looks like we've got a great scene there today in Piscataway. And we've got to start our halftime breakdown with this superstar running back. His elusiveness, his raw power. This young man is the total package. And his ability to catch the ball out of the backfield is a differentiator. A lot of guys can hit the hole. This kid can hit the hole and hit the home run in the passing game. And with that, let's send it back to the guys inside the birthplace of college football.
And the Bruins will try to kick this one deep to get things underway in the second half. On the run from inside his own five. He was looking for some running room, but not much to be found as he stopped at the 18. Rutgers has it back. They'll send the offense back onto the field. Going to the run to start this second half. They stop him after a 6-yard run out to the 24. Got six on first down. Now a lot of options on second and four. Pulls it and fires to the left. And they reacted well to the completion, but it was too late to keep them from getting the first down. They'll snap this one from the 32. It's first down. He'll put the tight end in motion. On the ground, it's Monaga. At the 45 on his way. And he found plenty of running room on that one before the defense was finally able to get him down.
There's really no secret to it, David. When this guy's running well, this offense is so hard to stop.
It opens up everything, and he's having a great day, showing you a little bit of everything, and this offense has got it rolling on the ground.
Off the play fake on first down to throw. He's got it. He'll work his way down to the 28.
And this is why it's so important, David, to get the run game going, because it sets up play action and gives them an opportunity to take these types of shots down the field.
And it's just so hard because as a defensive lineman, when you give the play action, I'm thinking run, I'm playing run, slows that pass rush down just enough and sucks those linebackers up, make those passing windows so much bigger. Nice job by the offense.
Well, this defense obviously knows they have to be able to stop the run now in the second half if they're going to win this game. And you wonder if they were able to make some tweaks and some adjustments at halftime, maybe getting some more bodies close to the line of scrimmage to give themselves a chance to come back in this game.
Got some work to do after that last play, second and 13. He's looking to throw. Got it in the middle, it's Miller. They make the stop, but not before he takes a chunk out of what they need to move the sticks.
When these wide receivers work the middle of the field, so much of this is feel. Understanding where the holes are in the zone or understanding how to get leverage on a man. And these wide receivers are dangerous nowadays because they do it so fast and see that so quick and make those plays over the middle.
They're bringing heat. And that pressure just engulfed him. A sack for this defense.
And the defense has given up some plays, some passing yards on this drive. You want to stop that? Nice job rushing the quarterback, making him feel a little bit of pressure and getting him on the ground and now getting him behind the sticks.
So here comes the field goal unit again. This kicker has already made three in this one. He'll need to strike this one cleanly from 48 yards out. Knocked it right through, showing that big range from 48 yards out. They're really starting to extend that lead as they get ready to kick it away again. The returner will field it and try to set up his offense in great field position. And they'll get him on the ground as the offense comes out to start the next drive. Motion by the back forces the defense to adjust. He's got the tight end.
I'll tell you, I love the play call on first down here. You're just trying to find an easy completion, and the shortest throw on the field for the quarterback is finding your biggest target, and that's the tight end. Nice job.
Defense trying to keep this offense from getting a line on who to block. The Bruins racing to the line in the hurry up. Power football with the run. That one could really put this drive into high gear as they have a first down at the 37.
Well, the defense is on their heels right now. They're going to have to find a way to stop this guy. When he's got a head of steam, boy, he is hard to bring down.
They've got it at the 37. It's first and 10. Looking downfield, it's Garbers. He makes the connection. You'll take this every time. 5 yards on the first down play. Offense, quick tempo. They'll run play action. Throwing right. And the pass is incomplete, jarred loose by the hit.
Well, the quarterback knew he wanted to go to his tight end on that play. He's a big physical target, but it was the hit on the play that forced the incompletion.
And this offense can ill afford to come up empty on this drive, already trailing by multiple possessions. Moving, keeping the eyes downfield. Oh, it's out! Defense swarming on that loose ball. It'll be a turnover. And he had an opportunity there to make something out of nothing, but things just got sideways and the ball came free.
I just like the effort on defense, okay? They couldn't get to the quarterback initially in the pocket. He starts scrambling and they don't quit. You saw all of the effort of everybody pursuing the QB, catching up to him, and them creating the fumble. Awesome job.
They'll throw it on first down. Quick completion on the out. He will step out of bounds, but not before the big pickup and a first down for this offense.
It's so important in football that wide receiver and quarterback are on the same page. They're understanding where I got to get the first down. Great job understanding where that marker was. Great execution, first down.
Wants to throw on first down. Got his man quickly. And a good job in coverage there as they stop it after just a few.
Well, the drag routes put in this playbook to fight against man-to-man coverage. So there you see the receiver using his speed, working his way across the field. He gets separation on the DB, trying to trail him, makes the catch, turns it upfield for the first.
Here comes the offense on second down. Quarterback on the keeper. Really nice stop there from this senior leader.
Yeah, it's a nice job by this defense understanding, listen, that QB is a threat. And they're going to run all kinds of options, and he's going to run the football. They were dialed in and got that sucker to the ground.
They've worked it down to the 30. This defense standing tall, trying to force a field goal try. From the gun, wants to pass. Caught over the middle. It's Miller. Good tackle there to stop him short of the first down. It'll bring up a big decision.
Ooh, and that's a nice sigh of relief for the defense, too, right? There was a broken tackle. The guy made it look like he was going to pick up the first, but because of great effort defensively, they were able to get the stop, and now they're setting up fourth down.
And now on fourth down, they'll try a field goal. And the kicker delivers the three to salvage that drive. And now the lead is even bigger. They keep pushing that lead out, and the kickoff team's getting some work. On the move from inside his five. And the return man has no place to run, no place to hide, and a place to be tackled. UCLA will go back to work on offense. Off the play fake on first down, wants to throw. Grab behind the line. It's Harden. And I think they'll give him two on that one, second and eight coming up. Well, he made the grab, but the doors closed quickly after that.
And I like this. I want to find my running back. But, man, he's got to do a little more damage after the catch. I need a stiff arm. I need a spin move. I need something where he can make that guy miss and pick up a bunch of yards and maybe get a big play out of it.
Grab behind the line. It's Harden. He's close to the first down, but they're going to mark him just a little short.
I want to get my running backs the ball in space as much as possible, and sometimes it doesn't work in the running game, but I can throw it to him. I can try to create some space out wide, dump him the football, let him make some catches, and see if I can't get some big plays out of him.
Guys, it is Rutgers on top here at the end of the quarter. And they are starting to pull away as we come to the end of the third quarter. Let's take a look at how we got here. One more quarter to play, and it might be unlikely, but hey, it's college football. Comebacks happen. Dropping back, it's Garbers. Unloads to the wideout. Got his man downfield. And they'll do more than move the chains. They'll move that thing more than 30 yards down the field before he's finally stopped.
The offense has struggled. They're not going to win this game. But trust me, this coaching staff is still trying to find things to build off of for next week. And after an explosive play like that, maybe they can generate just a little bit of momentum and gain a little bit of confidence that they can keep coaching up heading into their next game.
Comes out throwing on first down. Fires to the big fella. And good coverage by the defense, just a short gain.
Well, and here's the problem offensively, because you're trailing by so much so late in the game, the defense now is going to be playing big zone coverages, and they're going to allow you to throw the ball underneath in the middle of the field, rally to make a tackle, and bleed the clock. It's going to be hard now for this offense to claw their way back in this one.
The aerial assault continues. Finds his target down the middle. And he's knocked down, but not before moving the chains.
You got to give the O-line a lot of credit there, because it gave the receiver time to work all the way across the field on the drag route against zone coverage. Quarterback gets it to him. He's able to turn it up and get a first down.
And the Bruins are moving quickly down the field. Wide receiver now comes in motion. Looking to go up top on first down. Throws toward the end zone. And this will be incomplete. A big hit there forces second down.
Well, the defense really stepped up in this game. They knew they had to slow down this passing attack. They knew they had some matchups they were going to have to win one-on-one. They've been able to do that, and as a result, they haven't allowed 200 passing yards in this game.
They'll line up for a second down play. He's looking to throw. Catch in the middle. It's Sturdivant. They'll finally put the brakes on him at the three. A big throw, catch and run on that one.
Well, this offense knew coming into this game they wanted to try to attack the middle of the field in the passing game, and they're able to execute the in route there.
The Bruins line it up with a first and goal. Use the play fake, now to throw. Snagged in the end zone! Touchdown, Bruins!
And these are the plays that you look back on tape, and everybody's like, nice work, nice toughness, QB. To stand in there, know you're going to get blasted, but hold onto the ball till the guy comes open, feed him, and get the six.
Looking for the two-point try. Back to pass, it's Garbers. He's got his man. They'll get the two-point conversion, and now the lead is 14. About to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. And he takes this from inside the five. And good work by the coverage team to get the return man down on the ground. And the Rutgers offense heads back onto the field. Jesse, they had to kick a field goal the last time they had it.
Yeah, and oftentimes early in games, you're just trying to find your rhythm. Some things work, some don't on that first drive, David. It'd be interesting to see what happens here on the second drive.
Yeah, you got a feel for the defense now. You understand what they're trying to do, what their game plan is. Now you get to go into phase two of your game plan.
They'll snap this one from the 30 on first and 10. The give to the tailback. Dragged down after a pickup of five out to the 35.
It's a point in the game, I think, as a coaching staff, where you really challenge your offensive line to go win the football game, right? We've got a lead late. We're going to run the football. And the defense and everybody in the stadium knows that's what's going to happen. Can we run the ball down their throats and impose our will? That's what this offense right now is trying to do.
On second down, just keeps firing. Going to take a shot at this DB. And that's going to be incomplete, going for broke on second down, but third down's coming up.
There's a lot of QBs that when they get hit and when they get hurried and when they get pressured, they become very average. Really nice job by the defense, pressuring the quarterback.
These are the types of plays where offenses impose their will. Third and short from the 45. From the gun, wants to pass. Grabbed over the middle, it's Miller. And they'll finally get him down after a terrific pickup.
And you just get the feeling that this defense has to find a way to get off the field and get the football back at this juncture of the game, trailing late if they're going to win.
And the Scarlet Knights have it with a first and 10. Use the play fake, now to throw. Got him and nobody's close. And he found all kinds of room and got it down to the 28.
Defense just hasn't had an answer for this guy. He has been on point. This is about as good as I've seen him play at the quarterback position. And here in the fourth quarter with a big lead, he's still taking shots.
This offense is like running a perfection drill in practice against air, chunk play after chunk play, and here they come again. He wants to throw it again. He just got rid of that one to save the down, didn't see anything he liked. Now facing a second and 10 from the 28 after that last incompletion. Off play action. Fires to the middle. It's caught. They get him down, but this offense is set up first and goal from the 9.
There are a lot of offensive coordinators out there. A similar situation with a lead like this. They'd definitely be running the ball at this point. They'd probably take their starting quarterback out of the game potentially, but not this unit. They are still staying aggressive. They're still taking shots. They're just trying to light up the scoreboard.
They'll use the running game on first and goal. Forges ahead for 1 to the 8-yard line.
And this is a perfect situation. This is a situation, if you asked me to be in before the game, the coaches would have been in heaven. I got the football. I got the lead on their side of the field. Nice gain on first down. Same exact script. Do it again. Run the football. Run the clock. Let that thing tick down. And if we add points, we add points.
Relentless, tough running gets it down to the 4.
Yeah, and he's shown you a little bit of everything today. Shows you why he's a really good back. And the line's paved some holes. And he's right at 99 yards. And the way this game's going with the lead, he's going to get a few more touches, break that century mark, and when you do, you have a great chance of winning football games.
Wants to fire it in the end zone on 3rd and goal. Into the end zone, and it's caught! Touchdown, Rutgers!
There's no mercy rule in college football, man. They've got a huge lead here in the fourth quarter. They are still chucking it, and they are still scoring.
Getting set for the point after. And the extra point splits the uprights, and they're up a full 3 touchdowns, a 21-point cushion in the 4th. Just about set to kick it away. Here he comes from inside his own 5. Didn't find any crease in that kickoff coverage, and he'll be stopped at the 17. The UCLA offense is back on the field, ready to go to work. He'll come out throwing on first down. And it's incomplete. If you're going to take a hit like that, you might as well hang on to the ball.
You see an incompletion there. I think a big reason why this team is in such a hole right now in the fourth quarter is they have just not been able to find the explosive plays throwing the ball. And you got to wonder at this point, is it too little too late?
Now on 2nd down. After the incompletion, they go back up top. It's caught downfield. That's the kind of play that can really get you going as they get it out to the 36. They flexed out that tight end a little bit, and you know the tight end's always open.
Always open. Quarterback's best friend. And this guy's a problem, Reese. He's a matchup problem because he's too big for DBs to cover, and he's too fast for linebackers to cover. He's showing you his athleticism there.
Now from the 36-yard line, it's 1st and 10. Dropping back, it's Garbers. Got the quick pass. And he goes out of bounds after coming up with positive yardage there.
And listen, the defense playing really conservative, right? You got the lead, but here's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to get sacks. I got to get to the quarterback. Like, I got to make sure I'm getting him, knocking him off the spot. Padding my stats, by the way. Got a lot of sacks late in games when we had a big lead, but that's okay. That's what you're supposed to do. Keep competing, defense.
On second down, wants to throw. Quick strike complete. Now they're starting to feel it. They've got a first down at the 44. Quick timeout call by the offense after the play, trying to preserve every minute possible. Going up top on first down. Caught in the backfield, it's Harden. And he was fortunate not to lose yardage on that play, able to wedge it back to the line of scrimmage. It's nice to get a quarterback an easy completion like that, but it's nicer if they can go forward. And they did not that time, Jesse.
They did not. No, the defense was just better at the point of attack. Look at all these defenders, the shedding blocks and then getting hats to the football. That's impressive.
Off the play fake. Fires left. Got a wide open receiver. Smashes ahead. And he'll run it into the end zone. Touchdown, UCLA!
Nice job by the offense, going down the field, putting points on the board, but you're still down a couple possessions. Still need some good things to happen. You need your kicker to go over there and get warmed up. We need an onside. We need to score some points. We need a lot of things to go right to win this football game.
Now they'll line up for what they hope is automatic. Right down the middle. So that scoring drive took only six plays. And they finished things off with a 44-yard touchdown pass. They're definitely up against it. Time running out. Down two possessions. They'll try the onside kick. That's why they call them the hands team. They're able to secure the onside kick. Rutgers has it back. They'll send the offense back onto the field. They're in command of this game. Now let's see if they try to rub a little salt in the wound or happy with getting the W.
Yeah, and listen, this makes the post-game handshake fun sometimes. If you do choose to rub a little salt in it and keep chucking and keep scoring, I'm here for it, Jesse. Like, your job is to score points. It's my job to stop it. Keep the foot to the accelerator. Keep trying to play ball.
I agree 1,000%. That's like Steve Spurrier back in the day when I was playing for the Gators. You go and play for him because you want the opportunity to throw the ball. So when you get in the game late, you're not handing it off. We were beating Central Michigan by 80-something points. He was still letting us throw the football. It's the defense's job to stop you.